For those of you who don't know me, my name's Ratchet McClain. I'm a spy for the Cranberry Intelligence Agency. I've been at the counterterrorism desk for 7 years, and when trouble comes knocking on Cranberry's door, I'm the one who answers it. People tell me I have a drinking problem, but I don't know what the hell they're talking about. Due to a couple hiccups in my past operations, a lot of funding's been cut to the CIA. That's why I'm stuck driving a 1995 Grand Marquis, but hey, she's not half bad. The guys upstairs get irritated with me, but they're not the ones out in the field. They don't know what it's like. Some would say my methods are questionable, but I always get the job done, and I look damn good while I do it. Keeping scum off the streets of Cranberry's always been my top priority. I'd gladly lay down my life for this township. My specialties include hand-to-hand combat, small arms fire, and dark magic. Now, you're probably all wondering why I brought you here today, and well, you see, that phone call I'm about to receive, it's gonna change my life forever. Maybe you'll learn a thing or two along the way.
Ratchet, it's 5 in the afternoon, what are you doing?
Just my usual routine.
We have a live feed to your room. We saw everything.
Pretty impressive, huh?
I've got an assignment for you. Get ready quick, and I'll brief you in the car.
Anything for you, Traver.
Got it ready for you, Mr. McClain.
Thanks, Caesar. Not scratch, right?
No, sir.
Alright, Traver, I'm in position.
I said get ready quick! It's been an hour and a half!
I had to get something to eat, Traver. Can't do your little mission on an empty stomach.
Well, are you full now?
Yeah, I think I'll be okay. Let's see what you got for me.
This is a simple money exchange. Not even Caesar can mess this up. The target is a high-valued government asset, and our employers are willing to risk everything to get her back. This is where you come in. I've wired the money to your account, and all you have to do is pay the SAT. Get the girl and bring her back to headquarters. And Ratchet, this is a clean operation. So it is extremely vital that you do not compromise this. That means no killing. Do you understand? Ratchet, are you even listening?
Yeah. Got it. Kill everyone, get the girl.
Thank you.
right, boys, get her out. Let's go. Don't move. The buyer will be here soon, boys.
So did you catch the episode of The Bachelor last night?
Wait, do you hear that?
You know, we have some time before the buyer shows up if you want to maybe fool around.
I think I'd rather have you shoot me.
Oh, that can be arranged.
Hey! The boss is not to touch it.
Well, the boss isn't here right now, is he? What Mr. Vickers doesn't know won't hurt him.
I don't think you want to do that.
Whoa! Are you the buyer?
Yeah. Now hand over the girl.
No. That's not how this works. Money first.
Alright. Here's the thing. I don't have the money.
Oh, I knew the CIA would pull some kind of crap like this!
I'm not interested in making a purchase. I'm here to make a rescue. Now I'm gonna count to three.
Is this guy for real?
One. This is usually when a girl says thanks.
Sorry I'm late, guys.
You forgot one. Luger 9mm. Thought it would have had a little more kick to it.
Holy sh. What I want.
You blew it, Ratchet. You really did it this time.
Get your darn feet off my desk.
Traver, was it really that bad?
Yes. Not only did you manage to piss me off, he pissed off Vickers and his men.
Sure. I got the girl. I don't understand what the big idea is.
Ratchet, I specifically gave you orders not to kill anyone, and you killed everyone there.
I do not understand why you're mad. You have the girl, and just a couple people died. It went just as smoothly as all my other missions.
Oh? Oh, really? Smoothly? Let's have a look at your history. What's this? 15 nuns, dead, Madagascar. 19 school children in Singapore. What were you even doing there to begin with? Huh, look at this. You had to shoot the entire Cleveland Browns team. You could have got the information elsewhere. Hey.
Who the hell's Gold Town?
Give me that. That's classified. This would have been your next mission.
What do you mean, my next mission? What am I here for, then?
Ratchet, you repeatedly disobey orders from your superiors. You're the most reckless operative we've ever had.
So what? A few henchmen are dead. I've had a little hiccups in my past missions, but you know I'm the best spy the CIA has.
You left us with no choice after your little escapade last night. You're fired.
This is bullcrap. You can't do this.
Oh, yes, we can. I'm gonna need your gun, your keys, and that bow tie. Really? A clip-on?
I don't tell you to live your life.
This wasn't the first time that I got fired from the CIA, but Traybird seemed pretty serious. My suspicions were confirmed when I attempted to get into my hotel room the next morning.
My car doesn't let me in my room. Can you check it out for me?
Yeah, I can check that out for you, man. Can I get the last name, please?
Ratchet McClain.
1C, 2C.
Two C's?
You're Mr. McClain?
Yeah, it's me. What's the problem?
I received notice from my manager that you've been evicted.
Some homeless?
Yeah, dude, that sucks. Your stuff's over there. Get the hell out of here.
Yeah.
You're the most irresponsible, arrogant, saddest excuse for an operative we've ever had. You're fired.
Who the hell's Gold Toe? Gold Toe. Gold Toe.
Gold Toe.
Gold Toe sends his regards.
Remember, you asked for this.
That bathroom in Zeely was what I consider the lowest I've ever been. But there I realized the answer to the Gold Toe threat was in front of me all along. I needed to complete my last mission. And so I did what any reasonable man would have done. I broke into the CIA.
Ratchet?
What are you doing here? It's Sunday.
I always come in here on Sundays.
So there's no one else in the building, and you're just sitting in Trevor's office in the dark?
Well, I like the smell. But Trevor did tell me he was coming in early tomorrow morning, so I'm gonna have to tell him about this.
Let me get this straight. You're in here all alone, and nobody else is here that will bother us?
Yeah, Joe and Doug left about an hour ago. But like I said, I'm gonna have to report this break-in. Hey, maybe I'll get that new agent spot that just opened up.
I thought you'd say something like that. If I was an idiot, where would I keep my gun? Yeah.
that Ratchet McClain?
Rapaz, de jeito nenhum que aquele é o Ratchet McClain. Esse é um carro da CIA.
No, that's definitely him. Vickers has a huge bounty on his head. Let's get him. Let's bag him and tag him.
Meter vara nesse filho da puta.
For the first time in my career, I fell into enemy hands. My life was now at the mercy of the biggest scumbag in Cranberry, Vlad Vickers.
Senhor, ele está acordado.
Well, it's about damn time. Get the hell out of here. It's a pleasure to finally make your acquaintance, Mr. McClain. I didn't expect the infamous Ratchet McClain to be so easy to capture.
I didn't expect the infamous Vlad Vickers to be a ginger.
Shut your mouth. You have no idea how much I'm going to enjoy killing you. I respect your lust for killing, but you killed 5 of my men, and I can't let that go undone.
Killing me won't stop Gold Toe.
We don't say that name around here.
I have some information on that bastard in my bag that you might be interested in.
You don't know anything about that man. We've been in a gang war for as long as I can remember. The gold drove him insane. He's a cold, sadistic.
Just get my bag.
Fine.
My God. You have enough information in here to take him down for good. Where the hell did you get this?
Stole it. So what do you say?
Say to what?
I think we could put our differences aside for one mission.
Alright. But if you cross me, I'll end you.
I'll be reinstated in the CIA, and you'll kill the man you've been hunting your whole life.
Alright, so I guess we're partners.
Well, well, well.
Fat Joe?
What do we have here?
Me desculpe, senhor.
Never thought I'd see the day when Vlad Vickers was shaking hands with the spy, Ratchet McClain.
Damn it, Corleone.
Now, I don't mean to barge in on your little ditty here, boys, but Mr. Vickers, I believe you owe me some money.
I don't owe you a damn cent, Fat Joe.
First of all, it's not so Fat Joe to you, Mr. Vickers. And now, we can either do this the easy way or the hard way.
Now, come on, Fat... Joe. Let's bury our debt, and you can help us defeat Gold Toe.
And what's in it for me?
Do you have any idea the wealth that's behind the name Gold Toe?
How could I say no to that?
Let's do this.
End it once and for all.
Vocês são os filhos da puta.
I better get my money.
Dude, can you turn the crap down? We gotta come up with a plan.
What are you talking about? It's all figured out.
You have a plan already?
Yeah, it's simple. We go in guns blazing.
You've gotta be kidding me.
It's a good plan!
We do not have enough firepower between us to take down Gold Toe.
What are you talking about? Three Musketeers! And Corleone!
Yeah, we're gonna need more men.
I don't understand. You're Ratchet McClain. You're supposed to be some renowned spy. You killed five of my men, no problem.
Yeah, because they suck. No disrespect to you, Corleone.
Don't apologize to him. He doesn't understand our American customs.
I just don't understand. You're Vlad Vickers. You should have some big army at your disposal.
You don't understand, man. I had to give these guys some time off, okay?
You didn't give him time off.
Like I said, he doesn't understand American customs.
Well, regardless, we need more men if we're gonna take on Gold Toe.
How in the hell do you expect to get more men on such short notice?
There is one way. It's an old CIA trick.
Wait, you're not talking about
Craigslist.
Guys, been at this for hours. I really don't think we're gonna find any men.
Whoa. Click on that one. Heavy Metal Hank, Mercenary Mike, Soldiers for Hire.
Man, I love the color scheme that they used here.
12 years of experience, great with our hands. These guys are probably martial artists or
something. Wait a minute. They have weekend packages available.
Literally looks just like Sylvester Stallone.
8 a.m. to 9 p.m.? That's perfect time to take down Gold Toe, man.
$40 a session?
Oh. I say we go for it, boys.
Vocês são idiotas, né? Isso com certeza é um stripper, tá ligado?
Dude, do you even know what the hell he's saying?
I don't know. At this point, I just kind of go along with it.
Yeah, shut the hell up, Corleone.
Alright, let's go, boys.
I'm gonna stop at the ATM real quick. Mercs like cash.
Alright, you do that. I'm gonna go take a quick leak.
Watch who you trust.
What the hell happened to you?
Just drive.
Boys, this looks like the place.
You boys stay here. This won't take long.
Just in case.
Are you ready?
I was born ready.
All right.
Hi, are you Vlad and Ratchet?
Yeah, that's us.
Did you see our ad on Craigslist?
We did.
Okay, come on in.
So, you boys must be Hank and Mike?
Yeah, that's us. I like your mascara.
Do you have a bathroom or something?
Here, follow me downstairs.
Alright.
Place down here.
Oh, thank you.
We have a lot of high-paying customers.
I'm gonna go take care of some things, okay? You treat our guests nicely.
Please, take a sit.
So you guys said you had a lot of high-paying customers.
Yeah, actually, Hillary Clinton and Jennifer Lawrence were just here last week.
For protection, like bodyguards?
Something like that. Do you want anything to drink?
You have Diet Coke or something like that?
Yeah, actually we do.
Did somebody say Diet Coke?
Diet or lime?
You know what? I'll spice it up. Give me a lime.
Excellent choice.
Boom. Not bad. You're my kind of guys.
Well, you enjoy that diet lime. We have to go get ready for our presentation. You can go have a sit over there.
Alright.
You remembered the baby powder, right?
Of course I did.
There he is. Almost didn't recognize you without your mascara.
Coming from the guy drinking Diet Coke Lime.
It's a gentleman's drink.
Where the heck are Mike and Hank?
I don't think these guys are mercenaries. There she goes,
pulling up. Ratchet McClain and Vlad Vickers, this is for you. That's
alright. You might be right. Pretty things, nice thighs, yeah. Bad in a motherfucker, flying by. Yeehaw! Ain't nobody else touching.
Oh, I can't believe what I'm seeing. Shawty's the place that I ain't playing when I'm seeing. You boys hungry? You boys stay put right here.
We got a costume change for you boys.
How do you think Fat Joe and Corleone are doing?
Probably better than us right now.
Então tinha essa menina que tinha tudo pra ser o amor da minha vida, entendeu? Só que eu nunca consegui conquistar o amor que foi a mim destinado. E...
Dude, I have no idea what you're saying.
Eu tenho que atender essa ligação aqui.
Switch.
Wait a minute. Is that English?
Listen, the ginger will be easy, but the spy may cause some trouble.
Whatever it takes, but I need Vickers alive.
Alright, but I better get my money.
What did you just say? Poor Fat Joe.
You should have stayed in the car.
Hey Vlad, did you hear that?
I think that's our cue to get the hell out of here.
It was nice seeing you guys.
Nice see you guys.
Nice meeting you.
Coming so soon?
We haven't even brought off the whips yet.
Make sure to give us a positive review on Yelp.
Tell your friends.
Toodles.
That was messed up. Never speak of that.
I think they really liked it.
I think we're back in the business.
Wait a minute. Where's Fat Joe?
Ele disse que odiava vocês e foi embora.
He's a tool anyways. Agreed. Let's roll.
Like an explosion or something.
Dude, this is messed up. Your serpentine belt's cut. Dude, you're leaking fluids everywhere.
How is this possible?
Up. But the car was perfectly fine before we got to Mercenary Lights.
What could have happened in that time? I mean, I don't understand.
The only people that were in the car were Fat Joe and...
Hey man, you're gonna regret this, buddy.
Get on your knees.
How could you do this? After all the good times we had in Guatemala?
You killed my family. You took me away from my home country. You gave me a Hollywood nickname. I have no respect for you, Flat Vickers.
What are you talking about? I treated you like family, man.
Does family pay one another with Monopoly money? Godo pays more.
You dirty, filthy, backstabbing piece. Corleone.
Nobody saw Corleone's betrayal coming. He led us right into the hands of Goldtail himself.
Ratchet. Ratchet, wake up, man.
Where the hell are we?
I don't know, I can't really see anything.
Last thing I remember, we were under the hood of your car.
You got shot, man.
What?
Yeah, you got shot right in the stomach.
Who the hell shot me?
Corleone.
Corleone shot me? There's no way.
Yeah, it came out of nowhere. He was speaking English and everything.
I never would have saw that one coming.
Me either. You should have seen some of the stuff he was saying.
Like what?
He was talking about how I killed his family, how we don't respect him, crap like that.
Well, we were so nice to him. I mean, he never even caught on to the fact that we were paying him a Monopoly money.
Oh. He actually did catch on to that.
How mad was he?
He was so pissed.
Oh.
You should have seen him. He threw a wad of it in my face.
Oh, man, I wish I would have saw that. Where's the little guy anyways?
I don't know. He must have ran off, but Ratchet, he sold us out.
To who?
Who do you think, man? I think we're in the Golto Palace.
This place is a dump.
Wait a minute. These aren't even my clothes.
Ugh. These aren't mine either, and they... Oh, these smell like crap.
Wait a minute. You don't think that they...
No. We can't be thinking about that kind of stuff right now.
You're right. It's a shame that things had to come to this. But whatever happens, we'll go out fighting.
That's the only way to do it. Glad I know we've had a rough past and everything, but these past couple of days really made me see that maybe you're not that bad of a dude.
I mean, I always thought you were a tool, but a respectable tool, and a friend. I never thought I'd hear that song ever again.
Gentlemen, what a pleasant surprise. You can thank your little foreign friend for leading you into my trap. I see you've noticed the change in your clothing. We couldn't have risked you bringing in any weapons or goodies into the Golden Palace. I'll have you know Mr. Stockjob did a thorough examination of your unconscious bodies.
Wait a minute. That's that midget that attacked me.
Ratchet, where are your manners? Insulting the people that have shown you nothing but hospitality?
You call this hospitality?
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Vickers. I'll get to you in just a second. Now, Ratchet, you've been a thorn in my side for far too long. Your dirty methods have been problematic to my evil schemes.
Get on with it. Whatever you're gonna do, make it quick.
Oh, believe me, Ratchet. I'll be getting on with it. But first, I wouldn't be an evil villain if I didn't give you every single detail of my evil plan.
Here we go.
Shut up! It all started when I was a young lad. Your friend and I, Mr. Vickers, were childhood companions. We dreamed of opening our own gold mine together. But then, deep in the mines, something happened. A premature dynamite explosion caused the caves to collapse. Vlad saved himself.
You knew I couldn't save you?
You watched your only friend become buried alive so you could have the gold mine all to yourself. But down there, I was lost, starving. I had to eat my own toe for survival! I managed to escape the mine and flee to Austria, where I managed to complete my finest creation. The engineering marvel that gave me my toe back, in the form of gold. Come on, Ratchet, kiss it.
No.
Kiss the toe. Come on, just give it a little kiss.
Get that
kiss
disgusting it. Thing out of
You're
my face.
Kiss it? Kiss it, I say!
Oh.
I knew you'd come to your senses. Now, gentlemen, I present to you the Gold Bugs! A machine that smashes atoms at such an incomprehensible speed, it can turn any form of matter into gold. I call the process gold fusion.
What do you think you're gonna do with something like this?
Exactly what you are thinking. With the Gold Box running at full capacity, I will finally be able to turn the whole world into gold. Now, I would love to stay and chat, but I feel like a demonstration could speak louder than words.
No. No. No.
Blast! Stop! You can't do this!
Ratchet!
Blast!
Ratchet, man!
Blast! Vlad, no!
I'm not gonna get away with this, I swear to God! No!
Activate Gold Fusion Protocol 1933. Come, Stockjob. We have a hot yoga class we cannot afford to miss.
What about the spy?
Kill him!
Any last words?
Let's make it quick.
Don't worry, Ratchet. We're here to save you.
Hank, Mike, you guys saved my life. You really are mercenaries.
Well, yeah. What do you think we were?
Don't worry about it. Can you get me free?
Yeah.
I owe you guys one. When this is over, boys, Diet Coke Lime's on me.
You gotta stop him, Ratchet. You're the only one that can do it.
I can't thank you boys enough. You boys are gonna wanna get out of here. Things are gonna get ugly real fast.
You can do it, Ratchet!
You tall, funny, handsome,
cute. Now, now, he's got a job to do.
Toodles!
Firearm off you, Mr. McClain. May the best man win.
Alright. Let's do this.
stop job. We cannot afford to miss hot yoga. You know what to do.
Job, my home, my only friend. There's not much more you can take from me.
Then how about your life?
Guess again. I'll let you do the honors.
No. There's been enough killing these past couple of days. You're gonna spend the rest of your life rotting away in prison.
Respectable.
I like the new look.
It's gonna take some getting used to.
With Gold Toe behind bars, the citizens of Cranberry were finally able to sleep at night. Thanks to my dedication, valiant efforts, and dashingly good looks, I was reinstated into the CIA. I never saw a Trabert smile before. For once, everything seemed like it was gonna be alright.
Ratchet, I got another mission for you.
Now when the sun come up, I'll be there to say what up in the morning. Brush my teeth, find that clip I've been looking for since last night. I feel so caught up. I float somehow in my bedroom. Turn around, see myself in the mirror. I guess I'm cool. And no sappy thoughts in my head. I'm feeling like I'm Peter Pan. Minus the tights and the birds. Happy to see how far I've come to the same place. It began my dreams, imagination. Perfectly at peace. So I move along a bit higher. I'll be up a bit away. Up a bit away. Cause they don't trust me anyway. So whatever. I'll be up a bit away. Up a bit away. Cause in the end they'll judge me anyway. So whatever. I learn, I see the dreams I made. So I'm cooler now. I can take care of my mom. I'm alone in Surrey. So sing along, little mama. You ain't gotta worry about no drama, no. I provide for friends and fam and fans. I come to city grinding, man. Stay afloat, the kids hope. I never let them break me, dog. Who gives you food? Never don't like your steeds. Tell them it's off you and you tease. We don't care what people say. Dude, you critique your clothes the most day. I ain't gotta wait for no one. If I wanna fly, I can fly for free. Hey, I'll be up a bit away, up a bit away. Cause they don't judge me anyway. So whatever. I'll be up a bit away, up a bit away. Cause in the end they'll judge me anyway. So whatever.
is never the end. A new challenge awaits. A test no man could be prepared for. A new hell he must conquer and destroy. A new level of growth he must confront himself. The machine and the ghost within. This is the journey of the man on the moon.